Well, this show came about as part of the sesquicentennial that Northfield is celebrating this year. And the art department asked Ray Jacobson, Dale Hayworth, and myself to have a show here in Vallejo Hall.
Well, I'm Ray Jacobson, having taught at Carleton for 31 years, a long time. We were all colleagues working at the same time. I came first in time, followed by Dale, followed by Tim. I came in the fall of 1955.
And of course, Jake is an amazing man. Jake hired me. Well, actually, Jake and Dean Warnholtz were in the art department when I was hired. And so I had never heard of Carleton. And looked it up, and lo and behold, then sent a letter, and I got a call right away saying, would you come out for an interview? And that was in 1964. And I spent 40 years there. And still here. So I retired, a year and a half ago. Dale had taught history for a long time, where his career, he's an art historian. Dale started his art career, he wanted to be a studio artist, but and these are his words, he felt he wasn't good enough, so he went into art history.
Dale, as we know, is primarily involved with the history of art, but he had an interest in the making of images, anyway, drawing. During his travels, while still employed at Carleton, but certainly after his retirement from Carleton, when he traveled more extensively, I think he picked up on the drawing as a means of recording his experiences of traveling in various places around the world. From my earliest interest in art or things aesthetic, I was interested in the spatial. So I had a very strong interest early on in architecture. And as a matter of fact, when I left the Navy, I enrolled at the University of Colorado in the program of architecture for a year, but learned by the end of the year that while I might be designing architectural structures, I wouldn't be able to make these forms myself. And I felt unsatisfied or unfulfilled if I weren't able to make these forms. So thus I moved to the so-called fine art department, but pursuing printmaking and painting, began that persistence of intrigue with the three dimension, actual form and actual space, sort of became my primary focus. Thus, it's been sculpture for the last 30 years. The Bolio Fountain was a part of the Carleton Centennial 1966, and the architectural style of Bolio Hall itself played a major role in my arriving at what we see in the fountain. I realized that it would be a very part of the daily environment of students and faculty coming and going to classes in Bolio. So I built into the concept the capability for rotating, have it rotate. We set it up so that it was on a time clock and it would rotate one revolution in 8 days so that one would never see it actually turn. We just see that it would present itself in a different profile over the week. I like working with a range of scale from small to large and in between. So in the show, obviously, I was not able to bring any heavy pieces in. So photographs and drawings were the way of including those. So basically, this small exhibit in Bolio, I decided that I would show a number of the small maquettes. I'd like to show a few photographs of the working process that was involved in moving from that small-scale maquette to the large scale finished project in its intended environment.
It was just such a wonderful experience to have a show with Jake. Yeah. I just really loved that. We both did a kind of retrospective show. I hadn't planned doing that. I didn't know what I was going to do with this show, but I did. We ended up doing it kind of a retrospective.
The first piece is this silver casserole that you see here in this first case. And it was probably one of the first pieces that I did when I came. And then later I went from making hollowware to making jewelry, and most of the work that's in these cases is jewelry over the, let's say, the next 35 years until about 5 years ago.
I'm really interested in the process, working with a certain kind of material such as maybe copper or silver or gold or steel or iron or things like that, have a kind of cultural history for all of us. And I like to tap that in my work. I've been interested in teapots recently. They are kind of taken from a form of Japanese tea kettles and teapots called tetsubin. This is made out of silver, made in primarily in two pieces. This bottom part has been hammered up from or raised from a flat sheet, and the top was added to that, where there's a seam around here that put silver soldered in place. I haven't looked back, but I love the teaching. I love this studio too. Uh-huh. I love the time I can spend here and do things that I want to do.
Mm-hmm. It also gave me a chance to reconnect in a personal way with a number of Carleton students here.
Jake is still working, and I hope to have the vitality that Jake has, and he's 80, maybe 2, I think, these days. So.
It's good to stay in touch with Carleton and with the art department and the students who are taking art courses at Carleton. But the student life, academia still is definitely part of my life. The meaning of my life still resides in academia.